So I made sure that I wrote a little something for you guys. So good morning, everyone. Always believe that things do happen for a reason. I'm standing in front of you all because somehow it was meant to be. Whether I'm here to share something inspiring or a life-changing experience, for me, I'm here as a living testament that miracles do happen. Why? At a young age, I've accomplished many things in life. As a professional career as a nurse, bought my own house at the age of 30, I'm debt-free, a complete tight relationship within my immediate family, traveled many places at a young age of 20 and still continue to do so, then married the love of my life after dating of 11 years. We had it all mapped out to perfection and everything was planned out. Then 9 months after getting married, I gave birth to an angel. Her name is Adele. A Thanksgiving baby, and my world changed. My once workaholic life, career goal oriented personality is now loving the life of being a mom. I was depressed, I was sad, because I would rather spend more time at home rather than working 60 hours a week. One night, while walking around our neighborhood with Adele and my husband, I wishfully looked upon the stars and prayed, "Dear God, what if you make me sick? Sick enough that I stay at home with my lovely daughter. Sick enough to watch her grow up, but yet still be able to do a lot of things that I want to do in life. What if?" Less than 5 months later, I was diagnosed with stage 4 metastatic breast cancer. My cancer had already spread in my spine, my thoracic and my lumbar area, my pelvic bones, at the back of my neck, and all over my abdominal cavity. It's already in my lymph nodes. And then 3 months ago, I was then diagnosed that it's already in my brain. So then I undergo a procedure called cybernetic radiation surgery. And at this point, my oncologist said that my chemo treatments are indefinite. I knew that when my battle began 2 years ago, that giving up was not an option, especially raising my 3.5-year-old little Lima. I could easily live a life of despair, anger, sadness, and denial. I could easily give up, because I can personally relate more to someone who is dying than living. But instead, I chose to live a fulfilling life, because having a cancer is my path in life. It's not a burden, it is a path that I feel privileged to be chosen. So despite the physical obstacles that I face, difficulty walking and doing activities of daily living, or leading a life of physical pain, I am able to refocus, reassess, and keep pushing my body and breaking boundaries that in the naked eye is humanly impossible. Because with God, nothing is impossible. Everything in life has a solution except death. So with that being said, I'm standing here in front of you about to shake my behind and do Zumba, which is my first time. Despite the cancer cells actively lingering in my body, I am a living testament that miracles do happen. Believe it and you will achieve it. I am forever grateful and humbled that God had given me another day to live my life with purpose. And with that said, as you all stand in front of me, I want you all to think of someone that you know who has battled cancer or is battling cancer, whether it's breast cancer or whatever. Know that it is their path in life. It happened for a reason. Every step you all take as you dance away, not only dedicate it to them, but dedicate it to yourself. Love yourself, because it is the most precious gift that God has given all of us. My name is Julierose Sol. Think of me, pray for me, and thank you for your time.